greatest test. It says that life's a borrowed space, returned upon rest, a way of life.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu. Wa na'unzu billahi min shururi anfusina wa sayyi'ati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla la, wa man yudlil fala hadiya la. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear brother and sister in Islam, I'm your brother in Islam, Hussain Yee, al-khaadem, Malaysia. Today, we would like to welcome all of you to discuss about a very important topic in our life. That is how we can ask Allah for help. We need Allah to help us in our daily life. But how can we ask Allah? What is the best way to ask Allah for help? Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind us in Surah Al-Baqarah, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. وَإِذَا سَعَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ الدَّعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. Now Allah is telling us, if anyone asks you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about me, Allah, you must say to them, I, Allah, is very close to us. That means Allah is very close to all of us. And Allah said, invoke me, call upon me, so that I will respond to your needs. But Allah put two conditions. Before you want Allah to answer your prayer, make sure that you fulfill these two very basic conditions. Number one is فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُ لِي, meaning you must respond to Allah first. Whatever Allah wants us to do, we must try our level best to do what Allah wants us to do first, before we ask Him anything. Because that is the condition, the first condition. Number two, after we have done what Allah wants us to do, then you must have faith, or yu'minu bi. Deep in our heart, we must believe that Allah is listening to our prayer. He will respond, because Allah never breaks His promise. The only thing that we must have is patience, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to our need in the time that He thinks best for us, not in the time that we want. This is important. A lot of people don't understand. When they ask Allah for help, they forget. There's no response from Allah. You must have patience, because you ask Allah for help. Allah knows what is best for you. You must have patience and have trust in Him. At the end of the day, you are sure to see the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, this is my muqaddimah today. I would like to share with all of you, my fellow brother and sister in Islam, wherever you are, let us start our day with a short prayer that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam have taught us. There are many prayers that the Prophet have taught us, but let us start one of the prayers, a few of the prayers that highly recommended by our Prophet, peace be upon him. Now, I am going to recite it slowly so that everybody who is following this program can follow me to recite this short prayer. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala Ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. اللهم بك أسبحنا وبك أمسينا وبك نحيا وبك نموت وإليك النشور بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم رضيت بالله ربا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَ وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ نَبِيَّ وَصَلَّهُ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. The meaning of this short dua is, We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our morning, to bless our evening, to bless our life and our death. And to Allah, all of us is going to return. And we said, O Allah, give us maximum protection. And whoever seek Allah's protection from His name and attribute, he is sure to be protected by Allah. And the last one, the Prophet said, whoever said this dua, Raditu billahi rabba, O Allah, I am pleased that you are my Lord. I am happy to worship you. That's the meaning. And then we said, O Allah, I am so pleased and happy that I have a deen to live on. That means I have a guidance to follow. There is the divine guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And follow up, we say, O Allah, I'm happy that I have a prophet for me to refer to. I have a prophet who is the best example for me to follow. That is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. The Prophet said, whoever say this prayer every morning and evening, then Allah will be very pleased with us. So this is important. We must always remember Allah, then Allah will remember us. Because Allah said in the other ayah, in Surah Al-Baqarah, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ. If you remember me, I will always remember you. Now the beauty of when Allah remembers us, and when Allah is happy with us, Allah will summon Angel Gabriel. And he will say to Angel Gabriel, O Gabriel, I, Allah, love so and so. Can you imagine, brother and sister, when Allah loves you, He is going to summon the Angel Gabriel and He command Angel Gabriel to love you. And after Angel Gabriel loves us, Angel Gabriel will command all of the angels and say that Allah and Angel Gabriel love so and so. So all of you must love so and so. Allahu Akbar walillahi alhamd. It's a great nikmah. You want Allah love us because you feel safe and peace inside you. There's no more problem in your life, inshallah. And there's no fear for you in the hereafter because Allah is going to protect us and He is going to help us and He is always there for us. What is important today? Why? That when we ask Allah for help, we don't feel that Allah is responding to our prayer. Number one, I'd like to share with the brother and sister why in every khutbah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, may the peace of Allah be upon him, he never missed to recite the khutbatul hajah. Now I'm going to share with you the importance of this khutbatul hajah. Khutbatul hajah means this is like our opening speech where we ask Allah for guidance. We start with saying, Inna alhamdulillah, all praise belong to Allah. Now this is important. We must remember that all praise belong to Him, not to us. If anybody praise us, we must quickly say, Rabbana lakal hamd. All praise is for you, O Allah. So the feeling of pride, the feeling of riya will never enter our heart. Because by nature, human like to be praised. And when people start to praise us, we forget who we are now. We become boastful, riya comes into our life. So may Allah protect us from all this riya, because riya will bring us to shirk. And then the Prophet continued, Nahmaduhu, remind us to be thankful to Allah for all the bounties that Allah have given us. Wa nasta'inuhu, and don't forget to ask Allah for help. How rich you are, how smart and intelligent you are, how powerful you are, don't forget Allah, the all-powerful, the all-knowing. You need His help. It's important to ask Him and be humble, of course. When you want to ask Allah for help, you must be humble. And thirdly, وَنَسْتَغْفِرُ, and don't forget to ask Allah for forgiveness, because none of us is perfect. Being human, we must accept who we are. If we are not perfect, then we know that we cannot expect perfection from others. That will give us a better feeling between each other as fellow mankind, to forgive and forget, give and take. Now, this is important. The Prophet said, ask Allah for help and ask Allah for forgiveness. Now, if you don't ask Allah for forgiveness, Allah can forgive us anytime He like, but He would love us to ask Him for forgiveness. I'm sure that all of us want Allah to forgive all our sins, whether it's minor or major. And inshallah, Allah wa ghafur rahim is prepared to forgive all our sins if we are sincere and humble to Him. The Prophet remind us that always we must be thankful to Allah, and also we must be humble and ask Him for help. When you want to ask Allah for help, you must be humble, ikhlas, tawadda. And in the same time, you must ask Allah for forgiveness first. Now, when Allah forgive us, whatever you want, inshallah, He will give it to you. It's just like being a human. If you want something from somebody, the first thing that you have to do is to please the person. If you commit any sin with them, ask them to forgive you. When they forgive you, they are ready to give you what you want. The same go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Him to forgive all the sins that we have committed. Now, how to ask Allah to forgive our sin? This is very important. Everybody wants his sins to be forgiven by Allah. Now, I'm trying to explain to all the brothers and sisters in Islam the manners, the adab of asking Allah for help. Before you want to ask Allah for help, you got to ask Allah to forgive all the sin that you have committed. Because of the sin that we have committed, that stop Allah's help. When you commit a lot of sin, Allah may stay away from you. So now we want Allah to be close to us. We ask Him to forgive our sins first. Now there is a dua, the Sayyidul Istighfar. This is the best dua to ask Allah for forgiveness. Now in the content of this dua, the Prophet said, أَبُؤُ لَكَ بِنِعْمَتِكَ عَلَيَّ وَأَبُؤُ بِزَمْبِ فَاغْفِرْ لِي فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ ذُنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. It's so important for us, number one, to say to Allah, O Allah, I acknowledge all the ni'mah, the bounties that you have bestowed upon me. Now this is important. Everything that we receive from Allah is an amanah, is a risk. Eye that can see, the ear that can hear, the tongue that can taste, the nose that can breathe, the hand that can touch, the leg that can walk. All this is nikmah Allah. So you must acknowledge all Allah's nikmah. Now it's not easy, because normally we take things for granted. After you acknowledge all the bounties from Allah, the Prophet taught us to say, وَعَبُؤُ بِزَنْبِي, and I acknowledge my sin towards you, O Allah. It's not that Allah do not know all the sins that we have committed. Even the bad feeling in our heart, the bad thoughts we have, is a sin. The eye commits sins, the ear commits sins, the heart commits sins. We commit sins every day in our life. So it's important for us to acknowledge this sin. Because when you acknowledge the sin, that means you're very humble. You're very sincere. You cannot just, oh Allah forgive me this, oh Allah forgive me that. Allah knows, but He wants you to acknowledge your sin. If you can do all from A to Z, it will be better. Now when you ask, you acknowledge your sin, then you ask Allah, oh Allah, we know that there's none that can forgive us except you. You must acknowledge that Allah is the only one who can forgive all our sins. Fellow brother and sister in Islam, before we want to ask Allah for anything, please remember, you must clean yourself. You must stay away from things that Allah hates. Then it's easy for you to come closer to Allah. And when you are close to Allah, Allah is always there for us. Then the Prophet ﷺ remind us what to ask. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the all-knowing, the creator, when He created us, He knows our nature, our fitrah, that we are weak, we commit sins. And He showed us how to repent to Him. He sent a prophet, Muhammad ﷺ, to teach us. So we are very blessed, alhamdulillah. Because not only we have committed sin and then Allah just leave us like that, But Allah sent His Prophet Muhammad to teach us how to ask Allah to forgive us. One of the things that the best thing for us to ask, we say, "Oh Allah, help me." You see? Help me. What do you understand by the word help me? That means you admit that you are naive, you are weak, you need Allah. Only people who need Allah will say, "Help me." But if you are very self-confident, arrogant, you don't need anybody's help. So you need Allah, you say, "Oh Allah, help me to overcome the bad feeling that I have in my heart." Your heart. You must purify your inner self first. You must be sincere and humble. All is from here. Who knows whether you are sincere or not? Only you and Allah. So Allah wants you to be sincerely, submit to Him, acknowledge Allah's power upon everything, acknowledge the Creator. Then we say to Allah, "Oh Allah, help me to overcome the bad deeds." Now we are human, we always do a lot of bad things. So we ask Allah not only to purify our inner self, but in the same time, may Allah help us to do only good thing, thing that Allah is pleased with. Not just to do any deeds. If you just do any deeds, there are deeds that maybe is good for you, but it's not good for others. And when Islam is concerned, He always reminds us, anything that what Allah wants you to do is not only good for you, it will be good for your family and also for others. There is the difference between something that you think is good for you. Maybe it's just good for you. But what Allah wants you to do is always not only good for you, good for you, good for your family, good for your community. Now, fellow brother and sister in Islam, I did comment early, it's important to start our day by asking Allah to bless our life, our death, our morning, our evening. So that from the day one, the minute we wake up from bed, we are walking under the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will try our best. Like what I said early, we are no angels. Yeah, nobody is perfect, but we try our level best. And Allah loves those who try His best. Allah has said to us, فَاتَّقَ اللَّهِ مَاسْتَطَعْتُمْ. Try your level best to come closer to Him, to show your obedience towards Him. And also He said, لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. Allah also said to us, He will never burden anyone except what He is ready for it. So brother and sister in Islam, please remember that. There is other area that is very important for us to know before we come to the area, how can Allah respond to our prayer? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the all-knowing, all-seeing, He wants us to do something, at least some minimum, for the sake of Allah. That's why in one of the hadith, the Prophet said, Ya ayyuhan nas, inna allaha yaqulu lakum, muru bil ma'ruf, wanhaw ani munkar, qabla an tad'uni, fala ujibu lakum, watas'aluni, fala u'tikum, watastansuruni, fala ansurukum. Now this is a very important hadith for all of us to understand. The Prophet said, O mankind, indeed Allah have said to us, Muru bil ma'ruf, invite people to good deeds. Invite people to do good things. And forbid people from doing any bad thing that Allah says is bad. Before there will come a time, you ask Allah, Allah is not going to respond. Before the time come that you seek Allah help, He is not going to help you. He's not going to give anything. You ask Him for things, He's not going to give it to you. And before the time you ask Him for help, He is not going to help you anymore. He's going to leave you alone. Now this is a very dangerous situation. When you reach that point, you know that Allah is not there with you anymore. Now who can help you if Allah is not going to help you. We know that Allah is the only creator we have, the only God that we believe. So we hope all of us will try our best to do at least start within ourselves. That means you must always remind yourself to do what is good, what Allah say is good, what Allah want you to do. And you must try your level best to stay away from what is bad for you, what Allah forbid you. I'm not talking about just inviting others to do good things and forbid them doing bad things and you forget yourself. This is what happened in our society. Every day, we just keep ourselves busy talking about the weakness of other people. We criticize others, we forget ourselves. What Allah loves most is you must help yourself first. Save yourself first. Change before you want other people to change. So once again, I'd like to invite all the brothers and sisters, don't forget to remember Allah. Don't forget to ask Allah for help. And don't forget to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive your sin first. Like what I said earlier also, the hadith Qudsi, when Allah loves you, He summoned Gabriel and He will command Gabriel to love you. And when Gabriel loves you, He summoned the other angels and He command them to love you. Now, how blessed are we? You just think, if you are staying in a country, there's a king. And the king loves you so much. He summoned the prime minister. He said, the prime minister or the president, I so-and-so love so-and-so. Love him. I don't think the prime minister will do something against the command of the king. And the prime minister will call all the cabinet ministers. All ministers. This so-and-so is loved by the king. And I love him too. I hope all of you will love him. You become the most important person in that community, in that country. You have no more problem. What problem are you going to face when the king loves you, when the prime minister loves you, when all the ministers love you? No more problem. So this is important. Now, how to reach that point of love is very simple. Just do what Allah wants you to do in the way that He has chosen for you. Not in my way or in anybody's way. Even you want to make dua, don't forget. You must make dua in the way that Allah wants you to do. That's why there's one hadith, the Prophet did say, it's always important after the fardu prayer, the fardu namaz, the Prophet remind us to make a short prayer. Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Even you want to remember Allah, Allah never just said, remember me in any way you like. No. He said, ask Allah for help. The Prophet said, ask Allah to help us how to remember Him. Ask Allah to help us how to thank Him in return, to make shukr to Allah. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you to perform the righteous ibadah. Not just any ibadah, so that you will do the right thing, the thing that Allah is pleased with. Now we remember that the Khutbatul Hajjah that I have said earlier, this is why you see every time when I start my lecture, I always start with the Khutbatul Hajjah. And also, I would like to remind all the brothers and sisters again, we were going to guide you in the evening prayer. In the first episode, we guide you in the morning prayer. Now it's an evening prayer. I'm going to recite it slowly, inshallah. I believe all of you who is following this program is able to follow me to recite, so that Allah will bless you and also bless us and bless the Muslim wherever they are. I'm going to recite it slowly for everybody, inshallah. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma bika amsayna wa bika asbahna wa bika nahya wa bika namut wa ilaykal masir. Bismillahil ladhi la yadurru ma ismihi shay'un fil ard ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد النبي وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Now we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our evening now. The first episode we are talking about the dua in the morning. Now we are talking about dua in the evening. We say, oh Allah, bless my evening and bless my morning. We hope that we will live until the next morning, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and bless our life and our death. And to Allah, all of us will return. And then we say, Allah, give us the maximum protection again, because there is always some trial in the morning, in the evening, and there's always a different kind of trial. The night fitna is greater than the day fitna. And then we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the people that He is pleased with by saying, رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَا وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ نَبِيًّا. Meaning we say, oh Allah, I'm proud, I'm happy that You are my Lord. I do not worship anyone except You alone. And I'm proud that I have a divine guidance to follow in this world. I don't have to follow any man-made law, but I follow the law of Allah, that is Islamic law. And I said, oh Allah, I'm proud that I become one of the followers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So may Allah bless our morning and evening to the next morning. Brothers and sisters, one important point that I have said earlier, when you want to ask Allah for help, don't forget, you must ask Allah in the way that Allah wants you to ask Him. That is why any form of ibadah, because making dua, invoking Allah, asking Allah for something is a form of worship. Any act of worship is under the category of ibadah mahdah, a very special form of worship, not just general worship. Working to earn a halal life, to earn a halal income, also is an ibadah. Yeah, a smile also is an ibadah. Helping the poor, visiting the sick is an ibadah. But this is a general ibadah. When prayer is concerned, invoking Allah is concerned, this is a special ibadah. When you do anything that Allah wants you to do in ibadah mahdah, don't forget the shahadatain. The Prophet said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Now, what do you understand by this shahadatain, or the two kalimah? Number one, the shahada is reminding us that Allah always comes first in our life. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah said that I bear witness there is none worthy to worship except Allah alone. I fear Him alone. I always come to Him alone. That means whatever I do, I put Him in front of anything else. That is number one. Purely for Him. If you want to ask Allah for help, don't ask Allah through any medium. Don't go and do shirk and then ask Allah to help you. That's why Allah forbid any one of us to go through any medium or go through any intercession. That's why Allah said, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. This is the dua that we always recite in our prayer. Maybe we have been reciting this prayer 1,000 times. But do you understand what we are talking to Allah? What are we saying to Allah? We are saying to Allah, only to You we worship. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. That means we must worship Allah first. Don't ask Him first. Worship Him first. Then only we said, وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Then only we ask You for help. And only You we ask for help. What kind of help that you only can ask Allah? Anything spiritual. But when you are sick, example, before you ask Allah, what should you do? The Prophet said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ نَزَّلَ الدَّاءَ دَوَى فَتَدَاوُوا وَلَا تَدَاوُوا بِالْحَرَامِ. The Prophet said, Allah is the one who sent down disease, and He prepared a cure for it. There's a remedy for all disease, except old age and death. And then the Prophet said, you should seek medical relief. You should seek medicine. You got to look for a medicine for your disease. But do not engage in anything that is haram. You cannot say that if I don't drink whiskey, that means my liver or my cancer is going to extend, or is going to grow. No. Anything is haram, we are not supposed to take it as a medication. Seeking medication also is part of the command of Allah and the Prophet. He do not want you to just make tawakkal to Allah and say, oh Allah, I'm sick now, help me, cure me. But Allah wants you to seek medication. This is adab. You must make ikhtiar. You must work for it. So you see what Allah said, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. Allah is teaching us, guiding us. If you want to ask Allah something, you must worship Him first. And only Him, whatever you do, is to please Him. Because if you make any form of ibadah, you have the intention to please other than Allah, Allah won't accept this ibadah. And then what do we ask Allah? Brother and sister, what is the most important thing in our life when we want to ask Allah for something? Do you think wealth is important? Health is important? Of course. We all think that wealth is important, health is important. But compare with wealth and health, I think we prefer health. If you have the property with me, your money with you, but you are not healthy, you cannot enjoy it. But you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Kareem, Allahu Akbar, He wants us to know what is most important in our life. When we say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, immediately after that, what do we ask Allah? We ask Allah, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمُ. The most important thing in our life is to ask Allah to show us the right path. That's the most important thing. When Allah guides you and you act upon the guidance of Allah, you will have hasana fi dunya wa hasana fi akhirah. In this world, you will have all the good thing and the goodness from Allah, and also Allah is preparing for you Jannah in akhirah. This is very important. I know we need a lot of things from Allah, but what is the most important thing? A lot of us do not know. Even we have been reciting dua for thousands and thousands of times. Ihdina siratul mustaqim, ihdina siratul mustaqim. Oh Allah, guide me to the right way. Guide me to the right way. And again, you see, fellow brother and sister in Islam, when you make dua, you must not be selfish in your dua. And Allah don't like people who are selfish, who just think of themselves. I give you another example. We are performing salah, namaz. We are performing the salah alone. If you miss the jama'ah in the morning, you are praying the salah alone by yourself. But you still say to Allah, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Why not you just change the verses of Allah to إِيَّاكَ أَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ أَسْتَعِينَ. You are worshipping Allah alone. You should say, oh Allah, to you alone I worship, and to you alone I seek refuge or help. Why do you say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ, even you are praying alone? To show us, even you are praying alone, you are representing the Ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You would still use the word we, because that is a better word than to say I. No. We is always better than I. Even you are asking Allah, you are praying alone, you are asking Allah for something, and Allah still said, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Show us the right way. You can say, اِهْدِنِي إِلَى الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Oh Allah, show me. No. Not only you should be in the right way. You must make sure that everybody is in the right path. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alham, fellow brothers and sisters. If you understand the dua that you're asking Allah every day, then you know where you stand. Then you know that this world is not only for you. It's for everybody. And Jannah is for everybody. And we want to go to Jannah not alone. We want us, we want our family, we want our neighbor and our friend to go to Jannah together, inshallah. Now we discuss about Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. That whenever you want to do something, you must make sure you do it purely for Allah.
sincerely to please Allah. Nothing else but for Allah's sake. Then only Allah accept it. Because if you do for other purpose, or you have any other hidden agenda, Allah is not going to accept it. Secondly, even you are sincere, you are doing for the sake of Allah, you must make sure that you follow Muhammad Rasulullah. The way for you to ask Allah, you cannot just create your own way to ask Allah, no. The best way is to follow the way of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Why? Because he is the man who is chosen by Allah. He is the most closest person to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how can a person feel that I have a better way? My way is better. I don't need to follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. No, it is not correct. It is not right at all. I know sometimes we forget about that. We thought that I just want Allah for something. I will ask him. Yes, you can ask Allah. But try your level best to understand the way the Prophet have shown us, have guided us. That's why I just give you some example. Earlier, I have informed you about the zikr or the dua that the Prophet remind us to recite immediately after the Salawatul Khamsa, the five daily prayer. Number one that the Prophet always remind you to say is Astaghfirullah. Each time after the Farud prayer, what did the Prophet taught us? He said, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. You are just finishing your prayer. You are doing all the good things, the good ibadah. Why you must ask Allah to forgive you? If you are doing something haram, of course you should ask Allah to forgive you. But you are just finishing your fardu prayer and you said to Allah, Astaghfirullah, 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 3 times. Why? Because you may even commit sin while you are making your ibadah just now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do not want you to pray for the sake of praying. No. If you think that as long as I'm praying, I'm making my salat, my namaz, I'm okay, you are very wrong. You see what Allah said in the Quran. فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ. Hellfire for people who pray. Even people who worship Allah, Allah said, I'll put him into hellfire. It's a surprise to all of us. If those who do not pray, maybe Allah will punish them. But even those who perform prayer, he will be punished by Allah. Yes. Why? Because you are not worshipping Allah at all. You are just doing some exercise, some form of ibadah. Only your body is submitting to Allah, you make salat, but not your heart and your mind. Your mind is floating everywhere. And your heart is still entertaining a lot of bad things while you are worshipping Allah. There's no kushur. It's just a form. No more spiritual. And Allah do not want that. He wants you to talk to him not only with your body, your action, but with your heart and mind. It's 3-in-1. Salat is 3-in-1. It's a development of the mind, the development of the body and the soul. And Allah said, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Indeed, the believer, they are the successful one. Who are the real believer? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. A true believer is a person who establishes his prayer daily and he have khushu' in his prayer. He do not just perform his prayer, but he have khushu' in his prayer. Now we are coming back to why even we are praying that Allah is not happy, because Allah do not want you to pray to him just lip service, but also with your heart, your soul, your mind, and everything. Now, again, like I said earlier, why the Prophet teach us to say Astaghfirullah after our salawat? Because the Prophet know that we have a lot of problems in our life and we cannot be focused in our prayer. So when you are ghafla, no, that means you are not focused, you commit a sin. So you got to ask Allah to forgive you. But Allah is all forgiving. Don't worry, brother. I know it's not easy to reach the stage of khushu', but you can try. Now, how to achieve khushu'? You must follow Muhammad Rasulullah. That is why the two shahada is very important. Everything you want to do, don't forget Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah for the sake of Allah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasul, and you follow the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then you say to Allah, Allahumma anta salam wa minka salam, tabarakta ya jal jalali wal ikram. Then you continue by saying, la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la, lahul mulku wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. And later on you continue with other zikr, and in between this zikr, the Prophet still remind us to say, Allahumma a'inni ala zikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadati. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. We are the blessed ummah. That Allah loves us so much. When He called us to do something, He sent a man like us, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's not an angel, he's a human like us, to teach us, to guide us, to show us the best way, the best form. So we are the best ummah. Why not we follow the best? Why are we still following hearsay, these people, that people? Why don't we follow Prophet Muhammad? Because Allah said to us, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّنَ اللَّهُ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِكُمُ اللَّهُ. Oh Muhammad, say to the people, if they love Allah, they must follow you first. That means we must follow Prophet Muhammad, then Allah will love us. Now what do we understand by this short dua? I have mentioned in the early episode, but I got to go detail more, so we will understand. Even it's very short, but it's important for us to understand the ruh of this zikr. The Prophet said, ask Allah to help you to remember Him. Allah wants you to remember Him so that He'll remember you. Even you want to remember Allah, you cannot say, I want to remember Allah in my way, in my time. No, no, no. The best way to remember Allah is through your salawat. There are Muslims today who make a lot of zikr, but they don't make salat. They make a lot of zikr. The ahli tariqat, ahli sufi, sometimes they make a lot of zikr. But when it comes to salawat, they just take it lightly. Even making zikr, the best zikr is to follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After the prayer, the 5-time prayer, what is the zikr the Prophet taught us? That is the best way to do. How do you make zikr? You follow the Prophet, that is the best. The morning zikr, the evening zikr, what is the zikr that the Prophet remind us, taught us? I give you an example. There are people who like to make zikr by saying, we know the Prophet have said, after the zikr, la ilaha illallah. The best zikr is to say, la ilaha illallah. Remember, it's a complete zikr, la ilaha illallah. But later on, you have people who come to teach you, say, yes, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah. Later on, it's not important, la ilah. The nafi is not important. The isbat is more important. It's sufficient by saying, illallah, illallah, illallah. And later on, they say, illallah also is not important. Now we just say, Allah, 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 Allah. And then they will also, now they are trying to be more simple. They simplified it. They are going deeper, deeper now by saying, even Allah is not important. Say, lillah, 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 lillah. Later on, lahu, lahu, lahu. They are cutting all the letter one by one. At the end of the zikr, they say, hu, 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 hu. What kind of zikr is that, brothers and sisters? But the Muslim is involved in this kind of zikr that the Prophet don't even recommend, and he never make this kind of zikr in his life. Neither the companion of the Prophet, neither the four great scholars, Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi'i, and Hanbali, none of them make this kind of zikr. But we are doing it. Why? Oh, they said, we feel closer to Allah when we make this kind of zikr. Who give you that feeling? It's the shaitan who teach you to have this feeling so that you don't do the way the Prophet wants you to do. And then we say to Allah, oh Allah, help me to make shukr to you. After zikr, shukr. We want to thank Allah. How to thank Allah? The best way to thank Allah is to make sujood, to prostrate to Him. I give you another example. If you got money, how do you show thanks to Allah through the wealth Allah gave you? You are prepared to spend in the cause of Allah. You have help. How do you thank Allah with your help? You make use of your help, your energy to worship Allah, to do things that Allah is happy with you, to help the poor, to help the needy. It's very important. You have the knowledge how you please Allah, make shukr to Allah with the knowledge that Allah has given you. You must teach others. You must spread the knowledge, share it with others. Don't keep it to yourself. Use your knowledge to guide other people, not to mislead people. This is just an example. Whatever Allah gives you, you give back to Allah. That is the tithe, that is the shukr that the Prophet have shown us. Not like today, a lot of Muslims, shukr, yeah, shukr, alhamdulillah. Anything come in, shukr. When Allah asks something for him, for you to donate for the cause of Allah, it's okay, you know. I have paid my zakat, 2.5% per year. But you forget, Allah gives you rizki every day. If you really make shukr example, please, donate kindly to Peace TV. They are doing a good job. They are trying to help the Ummah to understand Islam through the media. You should be part of it. And the Prophet also reminds us, wa husni ibadati. When you want to make ibadah, everybody want to do ibadah. Even want to make ibadah, the Prophet says, ask Allah to guide you, to help you to do the ibadah in the best manner, the best way, the best form. You know that Allah is very selective. Allah do not just accept any amal. That's why in the Quran, Allah always said, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَامِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَعَامِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Each time when Allah talk about amal, He will make sure that He will say amal salih, not amal talih. Amal talih is just any amal, but don't follow the prohibition of the Prophet. Amal salih means the amal that you do for the sake of Allah, the way you act upon the amal, the ibadah, you follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. In his action, in his recitation, by doing that, fellow brother and sister in Islam, we are sure, inshallah, Allah will accept all our prayer. Allah will answer to our needs, inshallah. Allah never break promise. The important point is we must be sincere to Him and try our level best to do what Allah wants us to do. And Allah wants us to follow His last messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So please, don't ignore the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. وبالله توفيقي والأقر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Islam is a way of life, a complete way. Do you know what Islam says? It says that life's the greatest test. It says that life's a borrowed space, returned upon rest. A way of life, a way of life, a way of life, a way of life. Islam is a way of life, a complete way.